Buddy, welcome to my channel. The last video we saw about the deltoid muscle. I'm giving the link in the description box. You can check it out. So in this video, we are going to see about the biceps brachii. Biceps brachii arises by two heads. Short head arises from the tip of the coracoid process. You can see here, this is the short head of biceps brachii muscle, and it arises from the tip of the coracoid process. You can see here, this is the tip of the coracoid process of scapula. So the short head arises along with the coracobrachialis muscle, and the long head arises from the supraglenoid tubercle of the glenoid cavity. The long head is of course intracapsular. That is, it lies within the joint capsule. You can see here the origin of long head of biceps brachii. Now coming to the insertion of biceps brachii. So both the heads of biceps brachii join together to form a single tendon in such a way that the anterior fibers become the lateral fibers and the tendon gets inserted into the radial tuberosity. Can see the tendon inserts into the radial tuberosity. So the tendon also gives a band like structure, band like extension, and it is called the bicipital aponeurosis. It extends to the ulna. So this band is called bicipital aponeurosis and it extends towards the ulna. So what is the importance of this bicipital aponeurosis? So the structure which I am pointing out, this is the median cubital vein. So this aponeurosis separates the median cubital vein from the brachial artery. So now I am going to remove the median cubital vein. Just to show how this bicipital aponeurosis separates the brachial artery and the median cubital vein. You can see this is the brachial artery. So this bicipital aponeurosis just separates the median cubital vein from the brachial artery below. So you can see this is the median cubital vein and this is the bicipital aponeurosis. And here you can see the brachial artery. The next thing is the nerve supply of the biceps brachii. So it is supplied by musculocutaneous nerve, which arises from the lateral cord of the brachial plexus. So you can see here the lateral cord of the brachial plexus. This is the lateral cord of the brachial plexus, and here it is the musculocutaneous nerve. So the biceps brachii is supplied by, innervated by musculocutaneous nerve. So you can see the course here, course of the musculocutaneous nerve. Just I have removed the biceps brachii muscle. Under that you can notice the musculocutaneous nerve. So this muscle is the coracobrachialis. I am going to remove that also in order to trace the musculocutaneous nerve. So you can see this is the lateral cord of the brachial plexus and here is the musculocutaneous nerve. Coming to the actions of biceps brachii, it is a strong supinator. And it is also a flexor of the elbow joint. So both the short head and long head together, they are the flexor of the elbow joint, and the short head alone acts as a flexor of the arm. So another important action of the biceps brachii is particularly the long head of biceps brachii. As it arises from the supraglenoid tubercle, you can see here, the long head arises from the supraglenoid tubercle. So it prevents the dislocation of the shoulder joint. It prevents the upward displacement of the shoulder joint. So this is also another action of the long head of biceps brachii. So the next muscle you are going to see is the coracobrachialis. This muscle is the coracobrachialis muscle. It arises from the tip of the coracoid process, that too on the medial side. Here you can clearly see the origin of the coracobrachialis muscle along with the short head of biceps brachii. So now I am going to remove the deltoid muscle. I am also going to remove the biceps brachii muscle. So now you can see the origin of the coracobrachialis muscle. It arises from the tip of the coracoid process of the scapula, along with the short head of the biceps brachii. This muscle is the short head of biceps brachii and this muscle is the coracobrachialis. Now coming to the insertion of coracobrachialis. You can see the insertion of coracobrachialis. For my convenience, I'm removing the brachialis muscle also. So see, this is the middle portion of the humerus, right? So it attaches in the middle portion and that too on the medial border of the humerus. I'm now removing the coracobrachialis muscle so that you can see particularly where it gets inserted. So at this point, the coracobrachialis muscle gets inserted. So what is that point? It is just the middle of the humerus and that too the medial border of the humerus. Only medial border of the humerus, the coracobrachialis muscle gets inserted. Coming to the nerve supply, it is supplied by the musculocutaneous nerve, which arises from the lateral cord of the brachial plexus. So the biceps brachii muscle and the coracobrachialis both are supplied by the musculocutaneous nerve. To trace the course, I'm just removing the coracobrachialis muscle. So you can see. So in human beings, the coracobrachialis muscle, the two heads of the coracobrachialis muscle are fused together. So the nerve passes in between the two heads. So normally in human beings, third head of the coracobrachialis does not persist. Right? If it persists, it is just like a ligament, and that ligament is called as ligament of Schutters. Now coming to the action of the coracobrachialis muscle, it is a flexor of arm, and particularly it flexes the shoulder joint. The next muscle we are going to see is the brachialis muscle. For that I am removing the biceps brachii muscle. So you can see the brachialis muscle. So for that we must know some parts of the humerus. So first I would like to show that. See, this is the deltoid tuberosity where the deltoid muscle gets inserted, right? Insertion of the deltoid muscle takes place here in the deltoid tuberosity. So the origin of the brachialis muscle, it just embraces the deltoid muscle. So the origin of brachialis muscle takes place from the anterolateral surface of the humerus and also from the anteromedial surface of the humerus. It also takes place from, so the origin of the brachialis muscle, again I'm saying, it just embraces, it just holds the deltoid muscle. Because the deltoid muscle gets inserted into the deltoid at tuberosity. Just below that, the brachialis muscle arises. That is, the origin of the brachialis muscle takes place. So it just holds the deltoid muscle. So here you can see how the brachialis muscle has held the deltoid muscle. So in this you can clearly see how it takes origin from the anterior surface of the humerus, or the anterior border, not the anterior surface, anterolateral as well as anteromedial surface, but also from the anterior border of the humerus. So now coming to the insertion of the brachialis muscle. Now let us see about the insertion of the brachialis muscle. For that also we must know some structures or parts in the ulna bone to where the brachialis muscle gets inserted. So it gets inserted on the ulnar tuberosity. This is the ulnar tuberosity, the rough anterior surface of the ulnar tuberosity, and also it gets inserted to the coronoid process. So you can see this is the coronoid process. So let me show that from the superior view. You can see the coronoid process. So these two were the places where the brachialis muscle gets inserted to. The one is the ulnar tuberosity, the other one is the coronoid process. Coming to the nerve supply of the brachialis muscle, again it is supplied by the musculocutaneous nerve. You can see this is the musculocutaneous nerve, and of course it is a branch arising from the lateral cord of the brachial plexus, and its root value is C5 C6. So this is the nerve which also supplies the short head of biceps brachii, long head of biceps brachii, and also the coracobrachialis muscle, and now it also supplies the brachialis muscle. And another nerve also supplies the brachialis muscle, that is the radial nerve. Let us trace that also. So here is the radial nerve. Can see that. So this nerve is just proprioceptive. The motor nerve supply is mainly by the musculocutaneous nerve. So now you can see it is supplied by the musculocutaneous nerve as well as by the radial nerve. Now coming to the actions of the brachialis muscle. It flexes the forearm at the elbow joint. So this muscle also acts as a flexor, but for the forearm, as it crosses the elbow joint. So all those three muscles which we discussed in this video belong to the anterior compartment, that is the flexor compartment. Hope to see you in the next video. Do subscribe and stay in touch. Thank you.